tip of Europe, stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shores. Follow us on an exciting journey through one of the most unique and beautiful corners of Europe, a place where modernity blends perfectly with the ancient. An extension of Britain in the Mediterranean, which beautifully combines the best of both worlds. A lovely town where every street and every corner have their own story to tell. A story that even dates back to the creation of man himself. And its present-day independent spirit has been shaped by victorious battles, heroes, and legends. One of the pillars of Hercules, guarding the entrance to the Mediterranean. A special place which has captivated the soul of mankind throughout the ages. A city of reinvention whose economy is enjoying unrivaled growth, yet remains as welcoming as ever. Lose yourself in its charming gardens, old streets, and beautiful marinas, and feel the encapsulating spirit of Gibraltar become part of you. Be amazed by a place like no other, truly special, whose heart hides much, much more than you can imagine. Dominating the horizon at the southernmost tip of Europe stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shores. Follow us on an exciting journey through one of the most unique and beautiful corners of Europe, a place where modernity blends perfectly with the ancient. An extension of Britain in the Mediterranean, which beautifully combines the best of both worlds. A lovely town where every street and every corner have their own story to tell. A story that even dates back to the creation of man himself. And its present-day independent spirit has been shaped by victorious battles, heroes, and legends. One of the pillars of Hercules, guarding the entrance to the Mediterranean. A special place which has captivated the soul of mankind throughout the ages. A city of reinvention whose economy is enjoying unrivaled growth, yet remains as welcoming as ever. Lose yourself in its charming gardens, old streets and beautiful marinas, and feel the encapsulating spirit of Gibraltar become part of you. Be amazed by a place like no other, truly special, whose heart hides much, much more than you can imagine.
Double hit coming in. Double ones is a great number. That's coming in. He's going to make the 5 point because you want a strong board. Nope, I'm delayed. Oh, that's my thing going on. Okay. So everything pretty standard right now. 2-1. Oh, double two. Oh, okay. Much better for Thomas Moon. But Matt has some aggressive play available. He hits with fives, fours, twos, and he's got some seriously nice pointing numbers. So right now it's not going to be a cue. Have you played Thomas Moon before?
No, I haven't. No, not that good.
Okay. I've seen him play many times.
Yeah, he's a part of the Danish backgammon world, the team against the world, and he's always been a very strong player. So.
Yeah. Funny thing about Thomas Muir is that he always uses almost like all this time, so it's gonna be funny to watch him how much he will have left in the bank.
Yes, he does not budget early, but I've never seen him run out on time. So it's kind of nice when they're good players are hyper aware of how much time they have left. So as you can see, Matt still has almost 2 full minutes versus. That's an ace something. So we're getting the same glare you are. So we know there's a one up, but we're not entirely sure. Probably not. Oh, it looks like it's a double two or double ace.
Double ace.
Yep. Oh, yeah, it's got to be an ace. So, yeah, double ace. Yep. So if Thomas Muir dances with one, Matt's probably got a decent cue. And if he dances with two, he's got a double pass. And here we are. And Thomas comes in with a 5-3, so this is probably a double. Maybe playing conservatively, or I may just be hyper-aggressive. Yep, there's 4-3, too good. And now Matt's already overshot his market. So even if Thomas comes in, unless of course Thomas rolls double ones, which is a super joker, and now it's an even game. Fourth is not Matt's best. He wants something double ones for Matt. Yes, so he's making the bars, so now Thomas can't run out with sixes. And the other 2 ones are probably coming as one, and the other one's probably coming up as well. So he'll have 5, 6, and fours. Oh. Nope, so it's just sixes and fours. He wants to grab the high anchor. 6-5. It's going to be 2 in from that back checker, those back checkers back there. So at his 11 point, they're coming in. There they are. And here they are. And now Thomas is looking for some kind of weird magic play. But this is bad because he's going to have at least 3 loose blots if he does this play. So we're back.
So do you think that Matt should have doubled before? Before the 4-3?
No, I mean now it looks very scary. But
yeah, it does.
But 6-5, so Matt can save one or the other. And he's going to run probably the front one because that one gets pointed on with 4-5, 5-3, 5-2, 3-2, and there it is. And now, as long as Thomas doesn't roll like 6-1 or sixes, Matt should be okay. Okay, so this is interesting. So, you kind of want to not have Matt have access to an ace, because if he puts that other checker up, it really sucks for Thomas. But you also want him behind the prime. Coming into. We're getting another mic because I'm dominating the conversation. Okay, so here we are. Thomas has to use the 3 to come up because he wants the higher anchor, and then the 4 is probably going to be either out or down. Down looks good because now his 6-2, 6-3, 6-5 all make the 3 points. But this one now allows. Now this isn't right because he's duplicating his 3 to step up. So here we are. All right, that's going to be it. And as you can tell, Thomas is already going into his time bank.
Sorry?
Oh, you want to test it?
Yeah, test. This is a test. Double sixes?
Okay, so double sixes. Again, Matt stays out, and now it's getting close to a cube for Thomas Moore because sevens hit, and a lot of numbers make that 3 or 2 point.
So do you think that Matt can take here?
Oh, I can take here, but no, it's probably a pass. Just the position.
He does pass.
He kind of ran himself, and Thomas rolled those double sixes at just the right time, and Matt danced at just the wrong time. So,
yeah.
But again, both good play from both. I didn't see any glaring mistakes.
Yeah.
Aside from Matt not coming in, you know, that's kind of how that goes.
Yeah.
All right. So 6-4 standard opening play. 6-3 will be hits. Matt.
Yes. 6-3.
He's coming up. Six, Max hit back, and now his Reese is bad, so he's looking for a something 5 that's not a 6 to hit back. That's not a 6. So he hits back, but he gets another checker in play, so if this goes wrong for Matt, it's going to go super wrong for Matt.
6-5
is not
a funny 6.
Yeah, it's not a good coming for Thomas. He doesn't get a good hit, and he's got 3 loose checkers, at least. So Matt's definitely got numbers that hit him. So he's hitting with 4s, 5s, 2s. That's a lot of numbers and 6s. So Thomas just wants to avoid the double hit. So probably duplicates the 2 hit and the 2 hit on the 5 point. So this is probably the right play.
Yeah.
So Dan and I haven't come here at the tournament.
Yeah, I have. Yeah. Seen a lot of exciting matches, I think.
Yes.
A lot of good play.
I wish I could have shown you an exciting match.
Yeah.
The English just rolled over me like I was, you know.
Yeah. That happens.
It does. What's our beer budget here for our commentating group? We need to.
Actually, I don't know.
We
just put it on the tap.
We need to talk to the. We need to talk to management.
Yeah.
Okay, right now there's a lot of thought about this 6. He doesn't want to get double hit here. This is probably the right play because the hits come usually inside, so there's a response. This could be a really, some numbers, 5-5, 5-4, hit twice, 3-1. No, 3-1 actually works out okay. So he's either anchoring or making the 5 point. He's got to anchor somewhere probably, so.
Yeah.
It looks like he's making
one
the 5 points.
Oh, wow.
4 point. No, this is good. This is fine.
Yeah.
This is that other checker's trapped back. 4-2, not his best. So again, so probably he's coming down, making that outside 9 point, and then coming up.
Stepping up with the 2.
Yes. This one?
Both.
Okay.
Yeah.
I can talk. Usually my voice carries so much that people avoid me. Okay.
You're almost never asked to speak louder.
Right. No one has ever asked me to speak louder at any backgammon tournament. Okay. Matt just rolled a super joker double 2s, which was Thomas was a lot of times players try to duplicate numbers. So it's very rare to roll a double of that number. So Moore did, and now Moore is getting punished. And here comes the double from Matt.
I guess it should be a solid double.
Yes.
He's trapped. He's got some. I mean, yeah, there are checkers back, but he has no points. Thomas Muir has no points in his inboard, and Matt is looking to make a couple more. It's possible with like a 4-5, 6-5, 6-4. He points on his head. Matt, don't be a coward. Double the two. Come on now.
What can he be afraid of here, Matt?
Matt has a tendency to see ghosts. See 5-4. Okay, oh. Here we are. Two. Now it's two in the air, and now he's too good.
Yeah.
Unless, of course, he gives Thomas an opportunity to roll like a double three or nope, 4-2. If Matt doesn't cube here, then yep, there we are. And he flings it with casual abandon. Thomas was probably passing the roll before, so. Of course, Matt and Thomas are, I think they're 2-1, is there right? What's their record right now?
I don't know.
We don't know. Very strong players. They're a better record than my 0-3, so. In a cash game, that's a double. So 6-3 for Matt, opening again. Wide opening. You can afford to take risks early in the game. And here we are. Matt wants to come in with something six, not double six, but 5-4 is fine. He makes the high point.
Anger.
Mm-hmm. And here we go. Thomas Muir, he's going to close, and now the five is going to come down because he has no other five. You don't want to slot your ace in these positions. Matt's looking for some odd number pairing. There we are, 5-1, making the 5-point. Everything's looking pretty standard. No super jokers. So Thomas Muir is probably going to step out because he doesn't want to waste his checker that's on his midpoint right now. He needs that just in case Matt decides to leave with the five. Off the 5-point, Matt wants a four to recontain that checker, or a 6-5. Matt cocks his dice. Nothing interesting now. Double threes is a good number. That makes the bar point.
Yeah.
You don't want to make the three and have him escape. Oh, 3-1. So
saves the blot.
Yep, saves the blot and sits around. But Matt's got him cornered a little bit. Matt wants to see a 4-2, double four, or some big set so he can just run off the point. Sorry, I stepped away from the mic. I'm just not used to people not being able to hear me when I'm. I never needed to be microphoned. Okay, so. Matt's contemplating whether he can double now. He had a stronger double the last game, but let's go, Matt. Let's be aggressive here. Take some steps. Funny thing, we were talking about the clock earlier. Matt did time out at Nordic in the money round against Florin Papa from Italy, and it was a very heartbreaking thing to watch as his roommate because... You want to see your roommate do well, and he was 85% favorite against Florin at the time, but because the doubling cubes are different here, the clocks are different here, he didn't realize his time bank was actually his actual time. He thought it was his delay and lost the match. 3-1. Ooh, that is not a good roll for Matt. He doesn't want to get hit with the ace. He doesn't want to get hit with the eight, but you can't make another point inside. Well, you could make the four, but... 1-5, he's going to get hit. Thomas Muir hitting it on the ace, and then the 5 will probably keep going. So here's the hit, and there's the keep going. Okay, Matt wants a 4, and Matt rolled a 4, so Matt got the second checker back. That's really strong. If Thomas Muir doesn't get an anchor, 2-6 is one of his worst. He has to dump a checker or expose a checker. Either one he's not happy about. So, yeah, and dumping to the ace here is just maybe the only option, but it's bad, and Matt should be cubing right now. He's got a lot of numbers to make the 4-point, super strong board. Thomas Muir only has... 3 prime in front of him. That means those 3 checkers in front. Here comes the cube. And let's see what Thomas does. It's interesting. He's still got a ways to go. Matt does with his checkers. Daniel's updating his match.com profile, so I'm not going to expect color from him right now. I'm also looking on my Facebook and realizing I shared a link, and yeah. Aww. John Jennings pointing out that we can't all party all the time, but it seems that I do, and I can and do. So I respect that. And of course, Thomas passed. So here we are. Matt's got a 2-1 lead to 11. So that is 9 away, 10 away for those keeping score at home. And it's still anyone's game. Both players playing really strong. Now just when you get players this strong, it ends up being a total dice game. So whoever gets luckier, whoever rolls the set when they need it. Last round, we saw Kostin Bredl playing Volker Sonnebend, and a double fives from Kostin. The double fives from Volker kept his game alive, and then I think a double four or five from Kostin ended up winning for him. So Denmark took Germany. And here we are, 4-3. Everything seems fairly routine. Thomas needs to split those checkers. Matt needs to hit those checkers. So 6-5, he's going to make that bar point. So a lot of people call that, I don't know if I'm allowed to say it on this podcast or this this stream, but it sometimes gets hard to stick on that. Oh, but Matt rolls the Joker 3-1. So he's definitely in a commanding lead in this game against Thomas. Oh, 3-2, and now he's not. So Thomas has the high anchor as well, and Matt's got to come in and try and double fives would be a super joker, which would end this match, end this game, pardon me. 3-1 does not. 3 comes down, 1 shifts over. You don't want to leave a direct shot here. Thomas Muir looking for a 7, 6-3. So it looks like he's going to run all the way with that. Pretty standard. You don't want to get hit here, and you also have spares, so doesn't go to a bad place. If you break off the anchor, all of a sudden you're giving him 2s, 5s, and 7s to hit that loose checker. So here we are. And 5-2? Is that 5-2? Yep. Oh, no, it's a 5-6. So Matt's a bit stripped, but he's hoping that... Nope. Here's the ace point for Thomas. Or the slotting of the 3-point. Yeah, actually, better play. That's my bad. You don't want to strip off. But you also, with Matt being stripped on the mid, stripped on his bar, stripped on Thomas's bar. I like this play. It's strong. If Matt doesn't roll the ace, even if he rolls the ace, he may not safe the other checkers, and he's going to have some really good hitters. This is probably fine, but if you notice, every... Now, Thomas's outside checkers are all 2, 2, and 2. If he rolls any 6, he may be leaving a shot or definitely being stripped out. So I like this play. Saves the 6. Only gets hit with an ace. And even a lot of the aces, there's a lot of return shots. But Thomas opts against it. And Thomas time is ticking and ticking. So, okay.
Wow. Yeah.
That's going to be a little stiff for Thomas, 4-2. That's going to be just slotting the 2-point. Wait, what? Oh, okay, he's slotting the ace because he gets a still has a better roller. And here's the problem already, 6-1. So now Thomas has left that ace shot, and his board didn't get stronger. So if Matt rolls any 1, he is for sure hitting. And there's a 1. So he's probably going to keep them together. So he's going there. That's 1. That's 2. So maybe the bar, because he wants to contain it, just in case Matt gets hit with an ace, then that checker will be still trapped. So Thomas wants to come in here. 2-1 is a great come in. So he's got the hit, and then he's probably going to do the cover. Yep. So Matt needs a 2 or a 1 to come in. 2 would be preferable, because it would send Thomas's checker back. Okay, so Thomas is...
A non-hit.
Yeah, non-hit. I don't think that's right here. He's thinking maybe, you know, a little outboarded. That checker you don't want stuck on the ace point, but you also you have a good possibility. 1-6 is just a six. Joker. So Matt doesn't get hit with the 6 here. He's he got hit with the 6. But there's going to be a lot of checkers available. Oh, so, yep.
Yeah.
Thomas. There's a lot of dances here for Matt, which means his checker doesn't come in. But if Matt comes in hitting, he's probably hitting twice. 2-5. Ooh, 2-5 is duplicated, but 2-1, double one, 2-1. Yep. Two double twos. Ooh, double twos is a super salty one because it hits and makes the 2 point on his head, putting two up. So Matt's thinking about it. I believe he's thinking about it. Did Matt forget that he's playing? So they're both sitting there. Matt's time is clocking up. I don't think this is a double, Matt, but Matt's thinking if he rolls that two, and even if he doesn't, Thomas is still got three checkers behind his prime, and Matt's only playing with one. So he may be looking to double, which is a little more aggressive than his other checker play, but Matt gets flexible in these positions. And he did. Thomas will scoop that and say thank you. And Matt better come in and perform.
Seemed like there's a lot.
And Matt came in performing. So now Thomas is going to do a little scrambling here. He doesn't have time. He wants a two, but he doesn't have time to play this back game. So what Thomas is hoping is Matt will hit him again, and he will be able to preserve those checkers because Matt's got plenty of time for this game. 5-3, here we go. So this is just gonna go all the way. I'm gonna probably give him a six. Or he could actually break the mid and go to the five, not leave a direct shot.
How about just making the 1 point here?
No, he's gonna run out of time and those checkers of Thomas's are gonna move pretty fast, like this 6-2. You want all those checkers in front to just hammer the shit out of your opponent. So I don't know. I hope this is a PG telecast. But, you know, everyone who knows me knows this is how I speak. So, 6-2 is, I don't think Thomas is hoping Matt rolls some super large number and he rolls small. Because right now, 4-2 is just going to be making that point and splitting. So only double sixes is really good for Thomas right now, and even that's not crazy good. 6-1, and then he will lift. So now it's only a 5 that hits, 5s, 7s, and 9s. But Thomas does not have the time to play that back game. So he's probably going to be doing this and hoping Matt doesn't hit, and maybe he can roll a 5 and anchor up and withstand the onslaught. And 6-3 hits, and is hit. So now Thomas wants to come in with like a 2-6, a 3-5. 2-6 on the bar! yep, nothing. So he's going all the way. So he's hoping right now that there's some like awkward 6-4 something from Matt that doesn't close his prime. You gotta come up, Thomas. There you are. Okay. Matt's got decent shots at if he can contain this. 4-3, that's a great number.
Covers.
Yep. So Thomas needs some sixes to pop out to save this gammon. So, and he's already at, 6-4 is good. Comes out and covers. And now Matt's not as flexible. He rolls like 6-3, 6-2. 6-5 is okay. 6-5 is perfect clear. But because Thomas was able to pop that checker, Thomas is probably going to save gammon. So it'll be 4-1 Matt, barring any big mistakes from his checkers.
It's a 3-1, right? Yeah.
Yeah, 3-1 is fine. He's clearing off awkward numbers here, like 6-5 stuff. You can still play pretty easily. So Thomas is killing his big numbers, and Matt is rolling 6-2, so he's clearing the back. He's cheating and taking a kick. Matt's fine, and Thomas wants a 5 here. Yep, 5. Running all the way.
He preserves his board.
He preserves the board. He needs a 6-4 out of Matt.
2-3.
2-3. So Matt's just going to
clear from the rear.
We're clearing from the rear, and now you get to bear off. Double threes is 12 pips, but it's not as effective because he wasn't able to pop one of the other checkers out. 4-3 is going to be coming. He's going to peel and make the 2 point. because you want to. I mean, he's going to be. Thomas is going to be running. No, Matt, take off a checker, buddy. Okay, if Thomas rolls a big set here, he's could be. Nope, no big sets here. So here comes the crack.
He has to open something. Yeah.
Yep. But Matt's doing fine here. He's 6-2, two off. Thomas is still trying to roll a big set because 3-2. Thomas is limping along. Matt doesn't really have any really awkward numbers here. 4-1 plays. Yep. So now Thomas can run with impunity because Matt's not going to be able to hit and cover except with double ones, and even that's not the best hit and cover. So 5-4, and Thomas rolls 5-3, so he's going to go all the way. He doesn't really rate to get a shot this next roll, which is really bad because he needs some numbers to strip off. 5. Okay, so Matt's got Matt doesn't have any bad numbers with this. So
5-4 again.
4 is going to be all the way. And no. Oh, I guess double threes doesn't play the best. Well, actually, double threes does play all right. So I think Thomas is realizing that he's just now on gammon and save mode, and it's not looking like a gammon, but it's not looking like a win for. The win for Thomas. But a big set here can still make a difference. But we talk about wastage, which is checkers, extra checkers on the ace and two. They actually count against you in positions like this. So Thomas is not getting full value of his rolls because he's already wasted. Matt's going to be either peeling off or slotting. And 5-2. 5. Now he wants extra numbers. So it's either off the 5 or the 4, or the 6, I guess. So doubles, sets are, there's no real danger for Matt right now. He's got a 6 checker off lead. However,
unless he rolls 1-2.
If he starts limping, then he's definitely giving Thomas life. And you can see the hands tend to roll harder when you're looking for the bigger number. So...
And cogging the dice also.
Yes, Matt's
double fours.
Yeah, that's pretty much gonna end.
My
this.
Mistake, of course. It was from 6 to 4 before.
Yeah. 5-1. Yep, this is gonna be pretty much a handshake into the next game. 4-2.
Four.
Yeah, so 2 off and then 4. Yes, this is fine. Thomas needs set, miss, set. So set 3 off.
The first.
Is good. So he's still even, so he needs like a bad 2-1, a set, and that's going to be probably it. Yep, that's it. So here we are, 2-1, 22 minutes on the clock, and already both players have dented their clocks. But Matt does have a 4-1 lead, but that's nothing in backgammon. All it takes is a cube gammon from Thomas Muir, and he'll be leading 5-4. So
what did you think about the double? It seemed a little bold to me.
Hmm?
Doubling from the bar against a 4-point board.
Yeah, it's very strong, but the problem is that he's so far ahead in the race, Matt is, that it's hard for Thomas to get the full value of the take. So, but right now, as we see, Thomas is going to be going for Matt's throat and needs to get this. Oh, 4-3 is a nice anchor for Matt.
Anchor, yeah.
So this is gonna settle in to be kind of a.
Double
fives.
Makes 3-point.
Yes. But Thomas is also kind of running out of ammo. Oh, but Matt now has to volunteer a shot, and Thomas has a pretty good board, so there's the 3. It's probably going to be all the way. You don't want to have 2 loose checkers, get hit with the 6-3, 5-4, something like that. Double threes. Thomas is looking for that 3. Thomas rolls that 3 and 6-3. If Matt had done the other play with 2 down, he would have gotten hit twice. So Matt's okay with this. He wants to come in with a 4. There's the 4. Now the 5. 5 is interesting because he either is going to slash or come down. probably not slot the three, and he also doesn't want to go to sixes and fours. So yeah, it's a little stiff. Thomas is looking. Sorry, this beer is sponsored by, I don't know what they're serving, but every time you hear a pause, I hope you don't also hear the swallow. So right now, Matt's position is pretty stiff. So Thomas is thinking he rolls like a 4-6, something like that. He's got three checkers behind a 4-prime, or kind of broken, but still a 4-prime for Matt. So he could win this quite easily. So... But the clock begins continues.
So Thomas is looking to double here.
He's thinking about it. Yeah. He's definitely got him outboarded.
He's behind in the score. Yeah.
Matt will be taking because this is not hopeless for Matt. He's got a high anchor. He's still got some play. It's unfortunate that he's stripped off his midpoint. But
there are two blots.
But I played too many cash games with Matt for him to be intimidated by this. It's 4-3. He's playing simple. So he's thinking about coming up, but he's probably just safing the checker. Thomas doesn't want some weird fly shot, and then all of a sudden he has two back and he's scrambling. Matt's looking for double ace, double six is not a bad number for Matt. So he's going to take the three out and then come down with one, giving Thomas an eight. Because if he comes down off the mid and makes the two, there's a lot of numbers that pop, and then all of a sudden he owns all the outfield. So this is going to be it. And there it is. So Thomas Moore hoping for like a double four. Oof, double four would be crucial here. So three. He's got the better board, so he's trying to stimulate contact. He doesn't want Matt to be able to hem him in. So even though he's got a lot of numbers that point on him, he still has a lot of numbers that don't cover. So Matt's losing this race and doesn't want to get hit. So...
Yeah, Matt definitely needs to point on Thomas right now.
Yes.
Make a point.
Double fours, 4-3, 4-1, 3-1, all great numbers. But we'll still, some of those numbers still keep that checker on the 9-point, which means it could get hit. And Matt doesn't want to give up his 3-point lead, all of a sudden be trailing 5-4 when he was just happily running hot. So Matt's looking for a nice hit and cover. 5-3 is not that, so Matt's going to be coming in. He's definitely not leaving a shot. So he may be double slotting. He may be coming in, slotting the 4 and slotting the 3. Because he wants to build a board 2, and it's not going to be that easy to run. He's got coverage on 8 and 10, so that checker on Matt's 5 tends not to go all the way. I don't like this. I think this is too stiff. But he may be thinking he may have to hit and cover 4-1. 4-1 could be bad. So he didn't want the two blots because then he probably would have had to hit and have a loose checker inside. This way he's got like 3-2, 1-3 double ones that hit and cover that 3-point because he does not want to hit and not be able to cover.
6-5.
So that's those.
Nothing.
Yep. Doesn't do, but the race is still not too bad. So 5-3. Oh, you already made the 3-point, so now you've got some issue. Looks like coming down with the 5.
And slotting the 2-point on?
Maybe. Yeah, that doesn't seem too bad. Problem is that Matt, when he comes out with a 5, he's got 5s and 3s that Matt hit him with, but Matt's got 6s and 4s that cover that 2-point. So he doesn't want to come out and get hit and covered, and then all of a sudden the 2 cube he has is now a liability. So let's go Matt. Let's go Thomas. I know I shouldn't be biased, but Matt's my roommate, so even though I really like Thomas Moore, he's a very nice guy, so... I would not be upset. Either player wins.
Otherwise, you might have to sleep on the couch tonight, so you better root for Matt.
Well, considering what he left in the bathroom, I'm maybe staying outside tonight. Okay, so Thomas is spreading his checkers out. Okay, because Thomas doesn't want the same thing. If he gets to hit back, he doesn't want two checkers slotted inside.
He's not very flexible, Matt. He covers the 2 and slots the 4.
Yep. Super easy. So now Thomas wants to just run that checker away. It doesn't go away. That's being 10 away is kind of hard. Here comes the slotted.
Slotted.
Now you can come out.
Yeah, because Matt has a blot on the board. So
right, and now all of a sudden those numbers are duplicated. The fours and twos, which used to hit and then he had, which used to cover, are now the ones that have to hit and cover. So,
who's leading the race here?
The race looks like easily it looks like Thomas Muir. Yeah. So, but well, I shouldn't say it's too easily because also he's got a heavy 5 point. Matt doesn't have a 5 point, but those two outside. You got 30 there, those checkers, and then he's got 20 inside, so, yeah. Thomas Muir is leading 4-1. This is bite the bullet time. Matt is making the 4 and hitting with the 1, and he is praying against a 5. And if Thomas doesn't roll that 5, he may be seeing that cube or Matt playing on. He rolled the 5, and what did it come with? A cover? A cover that is lethally dangerous for Matt. So Matt needs to see.
Yeah, but
he can hit the double hit. But I don't think the double hits right here. He's now it's just 1-3-1-1 that Matt's that's good for Matt. Other numbers are just super bad. Yep, 4-2s staying out. And if Thomas hits that 3, there's a good shot of Matt getting gammon. Oh. Now Thomas is going to run. Matt's not going to have that checker picked up because that 6-1 would just play too bad. He'd give too many extra numbers with 1-3-1-1. So Matt's looking for a 1, and he needs it soon. Oh, he got it. 1-4. All right. So Matt's waiting, hoping there's an awkward number in the future. Oh, double 3s. That is an awkward number in the future because now Thomas's board weakens. He's got 2 dead checkers because the double 3s are blocked. Matt rolls a 4 here, and he's actually in pretty good shape. And he rolled a 4. And now he won't be slotting the ace. Will he? Okay. Here it comes. So 6-5. That one goes all the way. And now Matt is hoping he rolls like a 3-2, something simple, so he can make that point. And Thomas is hoping he can roll a big set to avoid 6-2. Okay. So Matt needs contact, and Thomas needs to avoid it. So double 2s is a great number for Thomas. He switches and comes in. He's against Matt's 5-point board, and Matt is back on getting gammoned. He doesn't come in with a 6. And he didn't. And now there's really only one bad number, 6-5. Okay. And so 5-2 now. Matt's got 2 returns, a 6-5 and a 6-1. And even then, it's not the greatest. 6-3. 6-3.
So the 3 comes closer? Or?
The 3, this is coming in. He's hoping, like, somehow Thomas rolls like a 2-1 or something that he's ends up getting that shot. 4-1. Yep, that's a great number for Matt because he's got that 6 possible. If he rolls that 6 right now, Thomas is in a world of hurt. 4-3. Nope, fan.
Dances.
Yep. 4-2. Comes off. Yep. So it's only double 6, double 5, double 4, and you're still with 5s and 4s taking off 4 checkers, so. But Thomas really wants this gammon, and Matt just sadly handed it to him.
5-4.
5-4. Off. Matt probably wants to stay up and hope for a shot-leaving number because this gammon's going to be hard to save.
6-4.
6-4? Okay. Oh. Thomas has some numbers. If he rolls any set right now, Matt's pretty done. But he does have the extra checker. Double 3s definitely save some gammons for Matt.
It does.
1-2.
Slotting the 5, maybe.
No, I think you don't want to waste here, so I think he should come in all the way from the back. Or even this is fine. There's still a bunch of checkers still. And that odd checker, it's so weird how that one different checker. So see, Thomas has 9 instead of 8.
Yeah.
That one checker costs so much. So you see Matt just bears into the six because he's just hoping to avoid it. And Thomas Muir is probably not getting this gammon unless Matt rolls super crappy or Thomas rolls the set.
4-1. Just one in.
Yep, still in. So Thomas needs a set here and he needs Matt to roll poorly.
4-1.
4-1. And here we are. And so what are we doing? 6-4, yeah. So that's funny in these positions that double fives is the only bad number, and we've seen it. If you play back him, you've seen it a lot where you go, oh, well, there's no way I can get gammoned here, and the next thing you know, I'll pop the...
Wow!
Oh, yucky. All right, so if Thomas rolls twos or better, and Thomas is shaking that hard, because you know he wants it. He's talking a little shit right now to Matt. Double fives come off now. So yeah, no. there may be a break after that one.
Yeah,
yeah. It looks like they may take a minute. Oh no, Matt's gonna keep going. I like his striped shirt. You can identify Matt by the stripes. And here we go. It's a good game. I mean, Thomas was. I mean, obviously it's super close, but. Thomas was one set away from taking the lead in this match.
Yeah.
42. Funny thing, Matt is I'm seeing Matt in Boston, where he's from. My wife and I are going down there for the tournament and also to see friends, but we're staying with Matt. But he's not playing in the tournament. He's going to be doing the commentary.
Really?
In Boston, so it'll be fun. Any shit I talk about him, I'm sure will be revisited on me at some point.
I know, yeah.
So. 4-3, nice number. If it was Thomas rolling it, but since it's Matt, it's just fairly simple. Double threes, here's the 5-point, and probably 3-point. Yep. So, right now, Matt's already outboarded. It's amazing how the energy when you're just cruising right along changes. Now Matt's giving him 7s, 8s, 6-2. Like 6-2, you have to decide whether you want to prime or not. Thomas Muir will be doubling here as soon as Matt hits the clock and picks up his dice.
He has the better board. He's a little behind in the score. He can hit a block.
Especially 3. 3 is such a magic number because you need 8 points.
Yeah.
So you want to get that gammon.
Yeah.
You don't give a shit about 1 point here. You want the 4.
Yeah.
You know, you want the 4 or the 6.
It has so much value to be like 4 away.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. The aggressive numbers. I mean, Thomas gets a gammon here, then all of a sudden he's 4 away. And one cube gammon, and that's some dangerous stuff. So Matt's got to make this play. He's thinking maybe he can hit and stop the tempo a little, like hit him on the 2-point. But I have a feeling Thomas is doubling with anything. There we are.
Yeah. Yes. So is this a take or a pass?
It's so hard in these scores.
Stronger board from that?
Probably a little bit of a take because you still got the 2 checkers back. But Matt did not want. So it's an even game. Matt doesn't want to see that. So that may have been correct there. It may have been a pass. He definitely does not want to go from leading 4-1 to now down 7-4. 6-4, a lot of different views on this opening. I particularly like this play. Makes 5-1 super awkward, makes some numbers play weird. A lot of people think it's a waste. After double sixes, it is a waste.
Now it's basically a 7-point match.
Yes, it's a 7-point match. And
is that changing anything, or...?
No, right now everyone kind of wants to slime a 1-point or, you know, get some kind of lucky gammon. Double aces is a great response for Matt. So the double fives kind of caught up a little bit of the race, but this now makes everything a little harder.
Steps up with the 3,
and then the 4 is probably coming down because you don't want to be dumping to the 2. But now, sadly, you get 4s, 3s, and 1s. That Matt is going to be trying to pound him on in 2s for sure. So you hate this because it's, that checker is just the only thing that checker can do now is the ace point.
It does look bad.
It's a dead checker. But he also knows that Matt because the score is even. Matt wants to change this momentum. He may be doubling. So he's got a lot of good numbers here that just pound him. And now that dead checker, that dead extra checker on Thomas's 2 point, maybe a little more of a siren song. So you got 4-3, 4-4, 4-1, double fours, double threes, and here it comes. And Thomas scoops. I like the scoop.
Yeah.
But regardless, he still needs to perform. 5-3 is pretty decent, so I think he's going to come down and hit. He doesn't want Thomas to get that anchor, and making the 2 point just doesn't seem like you do enough, especially since you've given up the cube. You want to just start pounding the crap out of your opponent.
Two points is bad.
Yeah, so here it is, and Thomas really wants a 4 here for some weird 1-3, 2-3, double fives.
Wow.
Ugh, killing the race, and... and making it look great.
6-4 covers with the 4 and the 6 down.
He's just going to come down. Yeah, he wants to, you don't want to slash there on the ace, and then all of a sudden you broke your prime. So double 4s, Thomas is not helping himself. So here comes Matt, 3-1. So that looks like it's going to be slotting the back of the prime. Or maybe even in, because that 3-6 is six. Just kind of a super joker, and he doesn't need to pay to it. So... yeah, it's an extra builder. I like this play.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
We agree on something.
We do. We gotta agree on who's gonna get the beer. Because I'm running out. Yeah. Oh, you got it? Oh, sweet. We'd like to thank our sponsors. Okay, we are now deciding the 3-1. And I think this is okay, but I really think Matt doesn't want to get hit here with the 3-6. So, 3-1, pretty good. I think you got to step up to the music. And then where's the 1? Ugh. The 1's not pretty. Slotting just gets you slashed. So... this is not boding well for Thomas Mu. Okay, and here we are. Matt's got some really good numbers here. But Thomas does not want to get pointed on, and he kind of wants to keep that anchor. So, that's sixes, fives, fours, and twos. Just slap Thomas as well as you may as well use that 2 that's wasted on the ace point, or even step up. I don't think this is gonna help you in the long run. So Thomas came down, but the clock already is ticking. 4-4 in 11 point match, but already he's got under 10 minutes, and Matt still has a lot of time here. Matt rolls a 3, he's hitting. He's probably going all the way because that duplicates the aces, and it gets a good cover for that 1 that's... 4-5. Matt's looking to point inside or roll a 4 and make the full prime. 4 is the full prime, and then 3 is going to be... coming in, yeah, I like this. So Thomas Mueller has some bad, like, 1-6, 2-6. I mean, it comes in hitting, but all of a sudden those loose blots are just painful. That 2-6, Matt wishes he was back there. He would have been able to get the other checker. He's got the full prime in front of him. You see those 6 checkers, there's no way he can escape. 6-6, so... a full prime still, and 1 checker in the air. So Matt will be running right along and trying to get this gammon and make up for the 4 he's so far lost. Okay. Yep. Fan, and Matt rolls a double 3, which is nice. 1. Probably going to come in with 1. and then decide if you're going to give him a 1-6 super joker. That's 2, that's 3. 1-6 super joker, but it saves against the... Yep, and there's the joker. And does Thomas Muir have it in his dice cup? He does not. But this also doesn't end up cracking Matt as badly. So he's going to come in with a 1-4-2, and then he's got some diversification. In positions like this, when your opponent's holding an ace point game, you definitely don't want to roll. I'm not that big a fan of this. 6-5 leaves the shot. 6-1, however, one roll late. And here's Matt rolling. 4-3 clearing. He's definitely not trying to drop his wallet on the way to the bank. And Thomas needs to roll quite well to save this gammon. Not that well, I guess. 6, and the 4 comes down. 6, and the 4 comes down. This is fine, too. Matt's barons, pretty standard. 5-4, 2 off. Only bad number here is 6-5. 5-3. May make the point. Oop. And that is the sound of the beer arriving.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Back from the beer run.
I love that about you. Okay. So the 5-3. He's looking to see what's going to be the easiest way to do this. He wants to make points inside, but he also doesn't want to get gammoned, so crossovers count here. And wasting pips may end up getting you gammoned. There's a 3, you're only wasting one check, one pip. And there's the 5. I like this play. Matt's hoping for sets. There's one of them, double 4s, so leaving no shot. But it's possible that Matt can... Thomas may want to split here, give him a super bad 4. Yep, there's the 3. There's the 6 down. Thomas is giving Matt a chance to roll like a 5-4, 6-4, which would double blot, which would be super painful for Matt right now. I hope I'm doing a good job and everyone's entertained. I know I'm not talking as much shit as I usually do, but I really like these players, so I feel like I should respect them. All right. Thomas is going to have to run. 2. And that's the sound of the microphones and the wires on the back. Now we're locked in. Okay. Now you can't leave. Okay. So.
I don't want to leave.
Yes. Thomas Moore has some numbers. If Matt rolls, it could be super bad for Matt, but he also doesn't want to. There's weird positions like here where somebody rolls like double 5s, double 6s, and all of a sudden now you possibly get backgammoned, which would be heartbreaking for Thomas Moore right now. And there's weird, like, double 2 switches and things like that.
Oh, you're not calling the double 5s again, are you?
6-1. See, this is a nice position, though. Thomas hits this. It's going to be key in saving his gammon. Fanning is bad. So now Matt has a lot of numbers that take off 2. And there's 2. Yeah. So... there's not just gammon chances here. Okay, so there's just gammon chances here. Because even if he rolls a set, he still has an ace shot. Once it's double 2. All right, Matt rates to leave a shot here. So, and Thomas really needs to hit it to save.
Oh, wow.
That is a painful number. So now, Thomas will be getting gammoned, and he may be getting backgammoned. So Thomas is hoping 6-1. He is coming out. So he's hoping that Matt rolls some ace, and he needs to roll a super high set to save this. So Matt is not cooperating. And Thomas needs to roll a big set here. 6-5, so there's the 5, and there's the 6 is coming, because now it's... He's hoping Matt rolls an ace, and he needs to roll double sixes. If not, it's going to be 8-4 Matt. Double aces, so he needs double sixes, or this is 8-4 Matt.
Didn't get it.
8-4 Matt. So.
Wow. Good game so far. I mean, it's very lucky shots from both opponents. The primes have been holding. Sorry, I'm tricking my Facebook because people are commenting. So...
So this score, like 3-away and many away or 7-away.
Yep.
What is special about that regarding the cube?
Yeah. So Thomas is looking to make a big splash. He's starting to run out of times he can cube, because if Matt gets just 1 point here, he's an uncubed gammon away from the match. So I think in this position, I'm not sure if Thomas would be. He's okay. So he's going to try and work out some kind of a little prime on Matt here. Matt just wants to run safely home, making the 5 point with the 6-1.
My point was just that Matt has to be extra careful with the cube now because he's 3-away.
Yes,
it's a little funny score.
It's very easy for Thomas to take and reship. Thomas would love to get a 4-cube on Matt and possibly win the game with a gammon. So Matt's going to just move up. Now he's got fives out. Thomas is going to try and close some stuff. 5-1, he's probably making the 5 point, because even if Matt rolls a 6, he's definitely looking at 4 prime in front of him.
He's got a solid position.
And if he rolls the 6, he may have like several loose checkers. Come on, Thomas, you know you're making the 5 point. Matt almost has double Thomas's time. Thomas is a great player, but he definitely looks at the clock a lot. So
maybe what?
It looks like double threes. Is that possible? So
with double three, the Matt would probably made the
bar.
Bar.
Yeah,
3-1. Way quicker.
Yeah, 3-1's fine. This is good. Thomas would love to see something that makes that other point, and he did it. So now he's got a 5 prime. Come on, Thomas. You know you're doing it, babe. You know you're doing this. So it's a nice builder inside, but it really doesn't accomplish what you want to accomplish here. Yes, you want to trap him. So this is the trap. Matt needs to roll an ace or a 9. Double threes is a 12. So 2 are coming down for sure, and then he may be blocking sixes. Yeah. So the sixes aren't coming off. The anchored checker, 4-5. 4-5. What's that? Oh, is that us?
Yeah.
is that the echo delay?
I just heard that the connection was low, but it seems like it's not so.
Okay. All right, so.
So prime versus
it's a prime versus prime, and definitely Thomas has the better prime right here.
Yeah.
So if Matt is forced off with something, or doesn't roll a set pretty soon, you're going to be seeing a cube out of Thomas. So Thomas wants to keep the 5 prime in front of Matt. So 3-1 is not the best. He'll cover the 2 from the 6, because you do not want to have 2 loose checkers. There you go, Thomas. Yep. And here we go, Matt. Matt's looking for sixes. 6-1.
6-1.
You may be thinking
about...
Goes to
the ace, or...?
Yeah. It's hard to leave your anchor, especially when you have all those checkers bearing on you. He's hoping an even number comes out. 5-3 is not an even number. So... Matt, all of a sudden, Thomas has a decision to make, running all the way. We're coming out with 2, and then 1s and 3s are duplicated. So this is interesting. I kind of like this play. It's nice to save 1 checker all the way. Now only a 6-3. But there are some picks and passes here. So this one seems like... So I think this is the right play. Alright, and here we go. Thomas Muir, clock's ticking away. But it's not going to come into play yet. Probably in two games. If it goes two games, Thomas is going to start feeling the pain, the time pressure a little more.
What is the difference here between the two plays here, in, like, game plan wise?
All right, so here's the problem. So Matt hits with ones and threes, but he's got a pretty wide open board. He doesn't want to get another checker stuck behind. 3-6 would be awesome because he hits and covers. So 4-1, he may not hit at all. Oh, no, that 4-1, pardon me, he will be hitting. So he's hitting here. He's hoping that he can avoid getting hit back with a 7. Of course, there's a 7 that doesn't work. Now, Matt needs to hit that other checker. He needs a 6 out, but he really needs to hit that other checker.
Double 3, I think.
Is that double 3?
Yeah. Ooh.
Okay. So now, kind of want to keep that 1 outside. You still want to hit him with an ace. You need time to roll a 6. So that 3 is probably going to be leaving some blots. So here it is. Thomas Moore would love to see a 3-5, a 3-6, or a 3-1. Anything that comes in and hits is perfect for him. 4-2 is not. But Matt can't cube here. Matt needs a 6. Their numbers here, double 5, double 4, that'll totally bust his
game.
Wow,
that was a 6.
6-2 is pretty huge. He's coming out with the 6, and he's safing that 2. So he's now it's down to just a 3-6, and the 3-6 is pretty good. But any 3, yeah. And now all of a sudden Matt may be too good. Matt rolls a...
He needs 6s now, both to come out and
yeah, but hit. He's not hitting.
No, no, of course not.
Yeah, 6. But he's going to be slotting a lot. So now all of a sudden 3-6 and 3-1 are huge for Thomas Moore.
Double 3s.
Yeah, double 3s also. 3-6.
Yeah, there it was.
There it is. And now Thomas Moore is in the driver's seat. So Matt's looking for a 4-6 or 4-5, 4-2, something that comes in. 1-6 is
wow.
Not the number. Thomas will be cubing here. Matt will be passing. So you don't want to give back those 4 points you just won. So. I think the cube from Thomas is going to be pretty quick eventually. As the clock ticks and ticks, ticks, ticks. There's a 12-second delay, so when people see, all of a sudden it looks like the clock jumps back. It's because the clock is red. You get 12 seconds, and it comes back into your time bank. Right now.
What's he considering here?
He's
maybe wait a roll?
Yeah, no, he's seeing what could possibly go wrong. In these positions, you got to see... with the super joker. If he doesn't roll the 4 or 6 out, all of a sudden Matt's got some numbers that not only hit him, but point on him. So he's got to be super careful that he doesn't get counter-punched. So it's not that easy to just leap over primes. But I think he's supposed to double, and I think Matt's supposed to pass. But Matt's happy if he spends 5 minutes and 26 seconds thinking about this, because then all of a sudden, the later games, Thomas will be playing as fast as he can. So, it should be interesting. So,
Matt's not using a whole lot of time. Is that normal for him?
Matt gets into time trouble at times, but in general, especially because Thomas is taking a lot of time, you can look at your plays while on your opponent's clock, which is super handy.
That's true.
I've never almost run out of time, even in speed gammon.
Yeah.
So I definitely lose equity like that, but I can get my opponents to play fast, which definitely helps my game. So,
yeah.
All right, so Thomas is contemplating, counting the numbers, realizing that Matt is actually down in the race. So, Matt is leading the race, that Thomas... If he cubes, Matt actually may have a take here, because the race is Matt's right now. So Thomas is counting, and we're counting down 4 and 15 to over 10 minutes difference between Matt and Thomas. Both strong players, but Thomas is very deliberate. He wants to make sure he gets this all right. He's probably playing at a lower PR. not saying that Matt's not playing well. I'm sure somebody's putting in this match right now, so we'll find out the PRs later. Here it is, and now Matt has the decision. He's been probably thinking about this whole time, knowing it.
So what are you doing here, Kara? You checking or passing?
God, I kind of want to take, but I always want to take. I want to see how this comes out. It's scary. It's scary because if Thomas doesn't come out, Matt definitely has some numbers. But if Matt just all that has to happen here is Thomas rolls a 6-1, and now Matt's behind a full prime. It doesn't matter that he can roll a 2. He's stuck. Yeah. So it's going to be a combination of numbers, but. You know, four primes, so Thomas Muir doesn't always escape that checker that's on Matt's 3. So if he can contain that checker, hit him, maybe get a dance, come up, then all of a sudden he can win the match. Because that's eight checkers that Thomas Muir still has outside. So we shall see. Matt's going to try and catch up to time Thomas. But I feel like he's passing this. Matt has a tendency to not want to give back all the points he just won. So we can wait and see. Oh, he took. I like this. I like this take because I want to see the man.
Let's see how this plays out.
3-1 again. Yeah, this is
kind of
one of the worst numbers for Thomas. He doesn't escape the checker. He loses a build. Well, he has a builder still, but a lot of numbers. 3-6, 5-1, 5-2, full prime, pounding, 6-4. 6-4 is bad for Matt. They're both coming in, and now Thomas is feeling a little easier. If he can make that 4-point or 3-point, he should be okay.
2 what?
2, I'm not sure.
It doesn't seem like it's higher than 4.
No, it's probably 4-2.
A 4-2?
Oh, it's 6-4?
6-2.
Oh, 6-2. Okay. Wait, no, it's 4-2. It's 4-2. It's 4-2. Yeah, that makes sense. Oh, it's double twos. Pardon us. So, yeah. So
that's why he's not running.
Yeah. So he's not running out, and Matt is hoping for a 2-1. Oh, double twos, actually. Is that a 2-4? We suffer by the same glare. Yes, for sure it's a 2-4 because he was reaching for that checker and there's no way he could touch it without it being a 2. So, this is going to be a 2-4. And I don't know what he's looking at. So, there's the 2. There's the 4. Yep. And now he's praying that a 5 is in the future of Thomas Moore. And a 5 is in the future of Thomas Moore. So... Thomas has a decision too. Does he slash? He just comes out. That may be right because this Matt rolls a 5 here. 5. As long as it's not a 5-1, it's only going to be a single shot. And Matt is commanding in this race. So Matt needs a 5. Double nickels is super painful. 5-2. He's going to run all the way. If he doesn't get hit by a 3, he actually has the race lead. Oh, 3 was crucial here. So Thomas isn't going to give him... Thomas is giving him a shot. He wants to make that 3-point really bad, but that 3-5 can come back and haunt him right about now. So Thomas has a lot of numbers to make the 3-point.
Double twos again.
Double twos makes the 3-point.
3 and covers his bar.
Yep. And so now Thomas has a full prime. He will slot with a 5 and hopefully get Matt to hit him and then pick up the other checker and try and get a gammon that way. 4-2. 2-4. This is fine. Matt's trying to come in, but gets slashed with a lot. And Thomas... We'll slot with the 6. Oh,
that was
perfect roll for Thomas. So Matt should save this gammon. The one checker gammon variation's kind of rare. Matt's doing a little counting quickly. So Thomas taking another checker off. 2 off. Matt needs to roll sets. Does not. Thomas needs to roll sets for the gammons. Does not. Put that, so that's 4 checkers off. So Oh, no, five checkers out. Pardon me. So Thomas really wants a set here. He wants to keep it even. 6-3. Matt needs to come in. And does not. Oh, wow. Now it gets a little complicated because Gammon's pay double. And if Matt doesn't come in here, he's going to be looking close to a gammon. 6-5 is a great roll for Matt. That should save it, even if Thomas rolls doubles. Two off. Yeah, this is gonna be Matt's game. To lose. Yep. Ding, ding. Two off. Game over. 6-4. 6-4. Muriclitis.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Yes.
Okay. I don't know why they're still playing. I think Matt is hoping for some. No, it's mathematically impossible, Matt. There we are. Okay. So it's amazing that neither has taken a break. So, but neither of them is a smoker. So I guess that makes sense too. And both have strong bladders and constitutions. No one had to take a bathroom break. They're young. They're both fairly young. So. Matt, being the consummate gentleman, was offering to give the points to Thomas, but Thomas figured he'd do it himself.
So A6, Matt.
Yes. And, yeah. Thomas was super close to a gammon at times. And then Matt just squeezed.
5-2. Yeah.
So in positions like this, sometimes you slash on the ace because then you give your opponent a super bad set.
That's
super
hit.
Yeah, you tempo hit, you stop like 6-1, 6-3, making the 5-point.
Yep.
Now if he rolls like 2-6, all of a sudden he's playing with 3 blots. Double fours does not do that. So, and then duplicate the 2s. 2s everywhere. Matt's hoping for, of course, double 2s. 6-2, we'll be hitting that outside checker. He sees it. He sees it. There it is. Okay. So that checker on the ace is just kind of sitting there like nothing. So he's not that upset about hitting it. So.
4 down.
Yeah. So Thomas has a nice little position. If Matt cooperates, he should be making a board a lot quicker than Matt. 4-3.
Four, oh, 3, yeah.
High anchor is huge. Matt doesn't get pounded. 5-3. That's going to be the 5-point. Yep. Plus he's thinking about making outside points, but no, this has got to be right. You want to make this. Yeah. Okay. There we go. Ace-5. That's going to be just safe.
Yeah, to the 7-point. The 8-point.
I knew what you mean. Even if the studio audience didn't, I know what you mean. All right. 2-1 coming. Locking up. Stopping any kind of weird double 2, double 4, double 5 onslaught. And Matt's just trying to roll a big set and get out of. This is a perfect number. So double aces makes all of a sudden an instant 4 prime out of a strip position. 5-4, both down, so it's going to be another prime versus prime game.
And Thomas has about, now he's under like 3 minutes on the clock, so.
Oh, double twos, this is good for Matt. Matt's got the prime, 6-5. Makes the 3-pointer, runs, but it runs to getting hit with a 6. Yeah, this is going to have to be Thomas's play. Thomas, you can't look at anything else. I mean, you can, but woof. So, you're giving him 6s, 3s, 4s, and 5s. It's a lot of numbers that hit. I don't like this play. I understand you gotta get off that, you have to get off that anchor and run, but this has gotta be it. And again, the clock's continuing to tick. Now it's at 2:18, 17:16, 15. So Matt's hoping Thomas takes as much time as possible to make this play. It's a key play right now, because being 3 away, 5 away, you don't want to get some weird slimy gammon hit. But if Matt rolls a 6, he's hitting double aces. He's shifting.
Shifting, yeah.
Yep.
But always a 3?
Yeah. Yeah, because you still keep the prime in front of you, and he's going to come down. He's going to come down with 1, and then that way he's bearing on the 5 point.
Yeah.
And also, 6 is pretty good. Oh, Matt's worried about the 5-6 joker. How's he doing that? 2-1.
Safety in 1 blood.
Yeah, he's for sure safety in 1 blood. And now it's, you know, that kind of weird number where Matt had the full prime in order, and now he's got that little hole Thomas is going to try and slam his way into.
2-4, I think.
4-2?
Oh, he's completing the prime? Oh, sorry, he can't.
He cannot. So, okay, so 3-5. 3-6. Okay, so even if he comes out, he's got a double shot out of him, so... The 3-5-3-6, which is the best number for Thomas, still leaves the shot.
6-5.
Yeah.
Or maybe.
I don't like this play because you don't get an extra number.
Only the other streaming.
Oh.
Finish.
Oh, the other streaming match that happened was Akiko Yazawa versus Michelle Lamont. And Akiko just crushed him 11-2, but Akiko, world champion, my Japanese sister, just destroyed Michelle Lamont. Probably wasn't even that close, so keeping you updated on the other matches. Michelle's a good player, but ooh. 6-1. Thomas is trying to keep stepping up and stepping up, but Matt rolls a 5-2, 5-1 right now. It's game over. 5-4. Woof. This isn't that great because the play, but the problem is now you give 2-2-6, 5-3, 5-5, 6-4, however. Matt's going to be looking. Nope. Matt's just thinking if he closes 2-1, 5 point. Yep. As long as he avoids the 1-5, the 1-6-2-5.
Wow.
Dwah. However, he's got a lot of returns here. So, if Matt doesn't come in 4-6, this will be a double from Muir. So, yeah. Here comes the cube. And this is a pass. Thomas did a little hand gesture like, oh, maybe, I'm not sure. But I believe Matt's smart enough to realize it's a poison apple and you just got to let it go. Because I love doing that. Like, okay, I guess I got some bad numbers here. But really, yeah, Matt knows. So, and he's also probably looking at the clock. But Thomas is in that dangerous territory. He's 4 away. You know, 4 away is... super efficient. You double early, and if you slime that gammon, game over. So I expect Thomas to double a little earlier than he's been, and Matt to be aware that if he gets gammon, that's the match. 4-1. Here comes some... Oh, it's not the hyper-aggressive play. That'd be slotting the 5, but I still think this play's fine. Oh,
double
and
five,
double
so
fives.
Hits and...
Yes. Hits and makes the point. So... Matt's hoping that he can see a dance, and he did.
Double 3, he dances.
So, you can't double it's here just because Thomas is such an easy take here.
5-4?
So, yeah, he's hitting.
Hitting on the 2 and covering.
Yeah, he's hitting on the 2. Come on, Matt. Stop playing. You know you're hitting. Oh, coming up. He wants a little more action? Okay.
Now he's forced a duplicated mess.
Yep.
5-4.
The 5 and the 4 is either getting hit or coming down.
Yeah.
So he plays this just because he realizes that Matt's got a better board if he gets re-hit. And Matt realizes that too. So 5-1 looks like he's got a hit on the 5 point. So I think the 5 is either down or out. I like down, but it may be out. But there's the ace. That's the five. The ace is heading. Come on, Matt. You know this to be true. You know this to be true. Yep. He's got some dancing numbers. Sixes, threes, and ones don't come in. So, Thomas Muir knows that. And one,
wow.
Six. Now Matt is rolling. He's going to try for an uncubed gammon if he gets some slimy number. 5-3, that's covering. Yep. So.
And again, that's because of the score he's going for the uncubed gammon.
He's being careful. He knows it's very easy for Thomas to take here and whip it back.
Yeah.
So
he gets the full reward, Thomas, for the full value for the gammon.
Yeah, but Matt's dice are cooperating quite nicely, so Thomas isn't out of the woods of the gammon yet. So Matt wants to look for a double four or some kind. Wants to make a 5.4-4-2. Looks like he's going to clear the back. No shots. So Thomas rolls a 2-6. So you're slotting the 3. You're slotting the 3. Come on, Thomas, you know this. There you are. You got a lot more numbers than make the 3 point, and the 3 point's going to be better than the 2. Now Matt does have possibilities of cubes because Thomas is anchored on his 2 with 3. Doesn't really get a lot of gammons here, but he wants the extra points. He wants to take away the cube action for Thomas for next game. He wants to go to Crawford. For those who don't know, the Crawford game means, oh, and here it is.
Doubles.
And Matt flinks, oh, and not even a blink. Okay, so this is a great score. 2 away, 4 away.
Even fire.
Yeah. So Matt's looking for an uncubed gammon, and Thomas Muir is looking for a cubed gammon.
And basically, Matt, he just can't cube here whenever there's any contact in position.
Yeah.
He has to wait before it's like a race, and he has a like huge lead.
Yeah, even the races are super dangerous because if you're even within 10% there, you get to take it and just re-whip it and make Matt choke. Because if Matt's playing for the match. If he whips that 2 cube and you take it, that's his match. So you need to whip it to 4 right away, so it's both your matches.
I think they're on a break right now, Carter.
Oh, cool.
You need to take. You want to take a 5
yes,
minutes? Well?
I would love to pee.
Yeah.
So, see you in 5. Break. Rolling.
Oh, the beer.
Exactly. So 2-1. Thomas could play aggressive here. He could slot the 5 too, because he definitely wants to make the board, and he's going to be cubing early to try and get that gammon. Yep, I like this play. Forces Matt to perform. And it seems too passive. So, yep, there we are. Okay, my voice may carry, and Thomas may be like, thanks, Carter. You know, like, talk. Oh, 5-1. Matt's rolls are not getting better. So he's going to slot the 5
slot
point.
The 5, yeah.
So, but the problem is that in slotting the 5 point, it doesn't duplicate anything. So he's got, Thomas has 6s, 3s. Okay, so yeah, this is probably a little better, but here we are. Yep, Matt takes, and now, as Matt said, he actually sometimes prefers being the 4-away guy instead of the 2-away, because one person lives in hope and the other person lives in fear. Matt right now is the one fearing. So,
oh. 2 beers.
You need 2 beers. Yeah. Oh, and our beers have arrived, which is awesome.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay.
I don't
know if you have, so I will bring
the
team.
Ah, okay.
Maybe.
Yeah. Okay, so, so Matt is now, Matt's in a little bit of trouble here. He's anchored, so that's probably not too gammonish. So, Matt's anchor is not too gammonish, but he doesn't want to send another checker back and get gammoned. Thomas is going to be pounding at Matt as much as he can, so here comes the 4. It's going to be a hit.
And of course, Matt himself, he can't win a gammon right now, or at least it doesn't
Matt
count.
Matt doesn't care. He's just got the 2. He got the 2 points, and Thomas is just hoping. Matt does a little bit of dancing, and Matt's hoping he comes in with a 4-6 or something nice. That 2-6 is not good. Now Matt's fears are realized, because 4-5. All right, so
come
probably
out
that,
or down.
I don't like the down. I'd like to come in, because he's not bearing on the checker as much. This only gives you double 5s to close, whereas that is now gives you 5-3, as well as double 5s is already a number that closes. So, yeah, this is the play. 5-6, Matt's fanning. 6-2. That looks like a 2, and then probably the 6 out. Because even though you're still trying to get that gammon, you don't want Matt to get lucky, and then all of a sudden, now you lose the game, you lose the match.
Continues to fan.
Yes, Matt is living his nightmare quite actively right now. That is going to come. Yeah, Thomas wants to bear on that 3 point. He wants that 3 point super bad. And Matt would like a 3-2 or a 3-6 here. Ugh. Again. And 6-4. So that's probably going to run all the way from the back. So now you're giving a 3-6 and a 3-2. But the 3-2 is lots of loose checkers. So Thomas isn't that concerned about that. Matt. 3-6.
Comes
that's
out.
A great number for
wow,
him.
And hits.
Comes out hitting. Yeah, he's maybe coming under fire, but he's going to trap a checker back. 5-6. Yep. And now Matt's trying to save gammon. And he does it easily if he rolls 6s, but 5-2. So Matt doesn't want another checker sent back, and Thomas is hoping he can roll a double 5 and close this thing. Double 3s also works.
Making the bar.
Yeah, probably making the bar. But it's not that bad to come down with both. I mean, your real concern here is making that 3.1 your bear in. So Matt's got a little bit of time here, 4 point. Matt's looking for fly shots. Thomas is looking to not get hit. And ace five will leave a shot. Now he has to decide whether the 2-6 is worth it. Yep, one checker variation. So now it's any two for Matt, and there's a prime versus prime situation because he's going to use the two to hit. Oh, 2-6. Yep. All right. So almost needs to come in. Oh, double fours. That is a sad number, especially if Matt is able to roll a 5-point home. 5-4 is not. So it looks like it's going to be a 2-point. Yeah, he doesn't want to strip off. I mean, he's going to have to strip off, but he definitely does not want to leave an extra blot. So there we are. 3-1. He's going to come in on 3 and slide over. So Matt is looking for a double 2, some kind of pointing number. Double 3s is perfect. Is it double 6s? It is
so.
Double 6s, yeah. So this is bad stuff. Oh, Matt is back on gammon territory, especially if Moore rolls an 8-7.
Wow.
That's perfect. So full prime for Thomas Moore. And now Matt is just hoping to not leave a loose checker. And
there was the double 2s.
There the double 2s. Roll too late. Everyone sees it. Okay, so how is he going to play the double 2s? You don't want to hit here, but you're also...
from his 6-point.
Yep. Yes.
Oop. Hold on, I think you blocked the door.
That's because I'm checking one tape.
You know, we got a problem because from here we cannot play to come with me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. How much is this?
Eight.
That's fine.
Yeah.
The lovely voice you hear is our server who's requiring our beer payment. So we're taking care of that right now as we watch the time. No, it's fine. Thank you.
Thank you so
much. Yes, take care. Okay, we've taken our break for beer. Matt is not looking too happy right now. And Thomas is thinking about giving him the 6 out. The only thing that could possibly go wrong is a double 6. And I like him holding a little more. He could come in better with that. You break the 6-point, he can run with the 6, but it's not. Matt still has a 3-point board. You want those to be builders there. That's a number that breaks that. So now you've got all these numbers. If Matt only runs with 1 to point on Thomas. And also, if you look,
yeah.
Thomas only has 18.9 seconds. So if Thomas keeps fucking around, if Thomas keeps messing around.
But there could be some important decisions at this stage in the bear in and the bear off.
Mm-hmm.
It has to be handled correctly. Like two.
Yeah. 4-1, just an ace. So he's not going to slot it because he slots it. And Thomas has even less fear. Double ones kind of
that
slid out of the park.
That should do it.
So Matt's hoping to roll 6 out. 1-3 to shift. And now the 6-5 is an overthrow number. Double 2s. Not afraid of the board anymore. Matt going to get 6 out. 1 just lifting. Thomas wants to avoid horror show numbers. 4-6 is not the horror show. But Matt really needs to start thinking about moving the checker. 2-3. Okay, Matt's getting himself kind of into gammon territory. That odd number checker is a little painful, but Thomas just took care of that.
He's going very
Matt
hard
needs,
for the gammon.
Matt needs to run. Double 3s is huge, so Matt goes all the way to there. Now the sixes come in, and as long as Thomas doesn't leave a shot.
Wow.
Sixes. That's a painful one for Matt to see. So Matt needs a double here for Thomas to roll a 4 next one.
4-1, I think.
4-1, yeah. He was hoping for Thomas to roll a 2 or a 1, which ends up making him on 3-2. It may be better here to bear off, right? Because if he gets hit with the 2, it sucks, but getting that extra checker off is huge. So now any set from Thomas, 3s or better, will win the game if Matt doesn't hit with the deuce. Matt has to run.
Doesn't hit.
No, it doesn't. And Matt has to run. He can't stay for another shot because the 6 has to play. So he's hoping that Thomas rolls an ace. And I think Matt's worst fears have just been realized.
Wow.
And that's the match. So
won the match.
Good game, good attempt by Matt. It's so sad when you're leading 2-away, 4-away, and they get that Cuban and you get gammoned on it. So, and also, Thomas Muir with only 15.7 seconds. Under pressure, the Dane comes through again. So well done, Thomas.
Yeah, well done. Good match from both players. And see you tomorrow for the 5th round of this tournament. Thank you for watching.
Yes, and
if
you like this, please comment and let us know, because I'll have a lot of free time tomorrow.
So yeah.
If people like it and I can get my beer sponsored, I will definitely be in the booth again. So,
yeah.
Good job, Dan.
So. Yeah. Good job, Carl.
Good match. Thanks.
Thanks. Bye.
Matt Reclitus lost. Thomas Muir. Yep.
Not yours. My match.
Oh, dude.
Yeah, crazy, man.
We were watching it. Well, you were not watching it. We were watching it.
Exactly.
You
should hear the soundtrack.
So, yeah, oh, it's a weird. Two-way, four-way, so we double.
What if the old cast of Brandon came over?
So, I was not last.
Dominating the horizon at the southernmost tip of Europe stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shores. Follow us on an exciting journey through one of the most unique and beautiful corners of Europe, a place where modernity blends perfectly with the ancient. An extension of Britain in the Mediterranean, which beautifully combines the best of both worlds. A lovely town where every street and every corner have their own story to tell. A story that even dates back to the creation of man himself. And whose present-day independent spirit has been shaped by victorious battles, heroes, and legends. One of the pillars of Hercules, guarding the entrance to the Mediterranean. A special place which has captivated the soul of mankind throughout the ages. A city of reinvention, whose economy is enjoying unrivaled growth, yet remains as welcoming as ever. Lose yourself in its charming gardens, old streets, and beautiful marinas, and feel the encapsulating spirit of Gibraltar become part of you. be amazed by a place like no other. Truly special. Whose heart hides much, much more than you can imagine.